And you also, I know, have worked really hard in the kitchen. You're a professional chef. You've worked in Italian restaurants, mm-hmm. and now you're at a French restaurant. You're making what exactly? I know pork.
It's a pork tenderloin dish with a poached pear red wine reduction sauce. And you get the pears here, the sauce, the pork tenderloin, kind of pound it out into kind of like a flat pancake. And the sauce, basically, you cook it down, red wine, Taylor port, a little bit of cloves.
Did you say port?
Yeah.
A Taylor port?
Yeah, a Taylor port wine, a little sweet wine. Yeah. You poach the pears down in there.
Oh, yeah.
And the chunky stuff is basically you take a pear, take a spoon, mash it into like a paste.
Yes.
And so like there's chunks of pear that go into, there's pork gets a lot of like certain things go with pork, like.
Like pears?
Like pears.
Apples.
Like applesauce, yeah. Most people do it with a loin, not like, or with like a chop, like a bigger piece of meat, and I kind of did it with the tenderloin.
And Jordan, I wanted to show folks how you do this, because this is kind of fancy schmancy what you did with the pear here, how you sliced it, right?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
So kind of give us an idea of how we can achieve that effect.
So when you poach the pear, after you quarter the pear and peel it, you poach it, and then you basically just take it on its side, mm-hmm. and you slice up the pear just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times and fan it out like a fan.
Nice, and it's really tender at that point because you've already poached it, right?
Yeah, exactly. So you just fan, you basically slice it 6 times, fan it, and then it just kind of fans out into like a nice little
hors d'oeuvre piece. Yeah, it really is a pretty, because again, we always say you eat with your eyes first, right?
Yeah.
And when you see pretty things like this, it just makes it even that much more inviting, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, so next is we're going to make the pork tenderloin, and you basically just took a pork tenderloin, you cut it in slices, and then you pounded it, and then it comes out really thin and tender. I can't wait. Okay, so you're gonna be making that for us. I tell you, my nephew's amazing, and you're also a stand-up comic, Jordan Zappala.
That's
your name, because I'm telling you, this kid is amazing on stage, but you can't really tell us anything right now because, well, it's not really for old audiences. Is that true?
Yeah.
Well, you could do a Seinfeld kind of thing where it's very clean. It's really adult comedy, but really for everybody, right?
Nah.
Overall, no.
I don't do like clean humor, so it's not like appropriate for everything. But I would.
Can you think of something semi-clean that you could share with us right now? I put you on the spot. I know. All right, we're cooking. Let's cook, and if you come up with something along the way, you'll share.
Of course,
right?
Yeah.
Okay. And by the way, I notice that you're using Sean Taylor's little spoon rest there for your tongs.
I went ahead and went and picked up some of these Sean Taylor shirt cover utensil rests. I really think they're the best ones you can pick up. Really do think they're great. Open the kitchen door. Go ahead and sit down. Eat with confidence and pick up yourself some Sean Taylor. They really do the trick. You want to go ahead and get yourself some of those.
Nice. You know, Sean is going to hire you as her spokesperson.
She better.
This should fall. Here we go. And by the way, I think caterers would use these like big time.
I mean, caterers can use them. People in restaurants can use them. Anybody can use them. You could use them in a barbecue grill. You could use them at the beach. You could use them indoors. I mean, listen, they're great. No one paid me to say this, but they're great. They really are great.
All right. Well, moving along. I'm sold. I was already sold, but now I'm doubly sold.
Me too.
Pork tenderloin happens to be one of my favorites.
Here, you want to take a few pieces, like whatever you're going to use for the pan. So, like, I'm going to say like about 4 pieces.
Yeah. Yes.
Season them with a little bit of salt and pepper.
Okay.
And then you're going to flour them over.
And look at how thin they are. They're beautiful. They're like little thin pancakes.
Yeah, it's like a meat pancake.
Yeah, which makes it nice and tender, I would imagine.
Yeah, and so you just want to make sure the salt stays in there.
Yeah.
And then you're going to go ahead and grab your flour.
Let's grab some flour and drudge it through,
and
right?
And just kind of real light. You don't want to like have a lot. You want to kind of just get like a light coating.
Just a light coating? Very nice. Now, you did a lot of prep beforehand. This is more of a special occasion meal because it takes a little more time.
Yeah, it's a special occasion meal. It takes a long time to prep everything, so it's not like an everyday thing.
Right, this could be a date meal, something special, right?
Yeah.
With the poached pears. I love it. That meat smells fabulous. It's partially cooked at this point, right?
It is.
Yeah, because you have to make the sauce to go with it. And this really is, I guess, the game changer, this kind of a sauce over the pork. So you have the port wine you mentioned. What else?
It's a red wine, a port wine, a sweet wine, It's got cloves. You poach the pears in the wine and basically just turn into like a pear infused wine.
I love it. And we will have that recipe on my website. So don't forget JanetZapala.com. So where are we in this process now, my dear? The meat goes back in here now?
Yeah, you're going to cook the meat with the sauce, and then you're going to have the salt from the meat and the sweetness from the sauce.
I love it. Here you go, my dear.
Give you a little bit of...
all those different flavor combinations are just exciting to think about. I can't wait to sink my teeth into this. And how much longer does this have to cook now?
You're just going to cook it for like another 2 or 3 minutes, basically, because the meat's already basically cooked. And that's going to kind of get the flavors in there. And then that's pretty much it. And then you're going to have your pork, your pear on top. The glaze on top of the meat, the pear on top of the pork, and that's pretty much it.
Talk about fancy schmancy here. What inspired you to come up with this recipe?
It's basically just a takeoff of a pork chop where the meat is just a giant piece of meat, and instead of going through all the trouble of having this giant piece of meat, you can just cook it easier in this tenderloin, and also the sauce will come through the meat easier when it's a thin piece of meat.
So it permeates a giant piece. The meat, goes right through it.
Yeah, exactly.
And so it's infused,
you get more flavor in the meat than if you get a giant chop.
Grab the poached pear right there.
You slice that beautifully.
Thank you, and you can take a little bit of the sauce if you want a little extra. You can kind of just like give it a little drizzle there on top. And that's pretty much it. And that's your poached pear pork tenderloin dish.
Wow.
And that's basically it.